Yes?
I'm Philip Marlowe. I got a letter asking me to come up here about a story.
Oh, Mr. Marlowe to see you. You may go in.
No, Dick, it won't do. Not enough gore. Not nearly enough gore.
Well, that's because you don't see it in color.
Color or no color, there's not enough blood. Take it out and put more blood in.
As soon as you finish, let me see it again. Mr. Marlowe. Oh, Mr. Marlowe. You're here about some kind of a story, aren't you?
Yeah. I got a letter about it from somebody named A. Fromsett.
I'm A. Fromsett. Adrian Fromsett, to be precise. Won't you sit down?
Thanks.
Let me see. I had your story.
You still have it. It's underneath the magazine there on the desk.
Thank you. If I Should Die Before I Live. That's a nice title. By Philip Marlowe. Nice name. Tell me, Mr. Marlowe, have you done much writing before?
That much?
Really? You do very well for a beginner.
Well, it's based on an authentic case.
Is it really? Oh, of course, we get hundreds of authentic cases submitted to us every week.
Why don't you print a few?
They aren't all as emotional as yours. Cigarette?
Thanks.
Light.
Thank you.
Besides, you see, people who write usually don't know the facts, and people who know the facts usually can't write. Authenticity has very little to do with it. If people who read our magazines knew the facts of life, Mr. Marlowe, they wouldn't be reading our magazines. Oh, Mr. Marlowe.
Yeah?
Thank you. Have you been marooned on a desert island, or do you just find it difficult to concentrate?
A little of both.
Really? In that case, I must be losing my touch. You see, editorial work is so unglamorous. Sometimes...
You run this business all by yourself?
No. Mr. Darris Kingsby is president of the company. I'm his principal assistant. Tell me, Mr. Marlowe, aren't there really detectives like the one in your story who never lie, cheat, or double-cross a client, who are loyal, honest, never betray a confidence?
Yeah, there are a couple of dopes like that.
Ah, good. Then your story is autobiographical. You were writing about yourself.
You don't really want to buy my story, do you, Miss Fromsett?
I was about to offer you $200 for it.
Oh, no, you weren't. Why don't you quit being cute, Miss Fromsett? The real reason you had me up here is because you're looking for a smooth operator who keeps his mouth shut. And when you read the story, you said, yeah, that's my boy. He's dumb, he's brave, and he's cheap. Am I right?
Well, I was about to offer you a commission on a rather delicate and confidential matter.
Then why didn't you pick up the telephone and call me instead of all this Mickey Mouse about a story?
What I want you to do is this. I want you to find Mr. Kingsby's wife without his knowing you're looking for her. She's run off with another man. She's a vicious woman, a liar, a cheat, and a thief. She may even end up in the hands of the police. He's had 10 years...
Pardon me if I'm nosy, Miss Fromsett. What makes this any of your business?
I handle all of Mr. Kingsby's affairs. He wishes to divorce her. She must be found before she can be served with the papers.
Nice job you have here.
You think I'm pretty cold-blooded about this, don't you?
I'd have used a shorter word.
I don't like your manner.
I'm not selling it. I'm not selling the story either to you. I'm not selling anything. I have an allergy against getting mixed up with tricky females who want to knock off the boss's wife and marry him for themselves.
People don't talk to me like that, Mr. Marlowe.
Maybe that's what's the matter with you. Somebody should talk to you like that sometimes.